My name's Jeb, and it's time to make some salad.
I grow weary of all the gardening rules we have to follow. Maybe that's why I grow so many things without soil. I'm gonna try to grow a salad with 5 different plants in the same tote. Of course, that has its own set of challenges. Different nutrient requirements, different maturation dates. Picking up 6 rockwools with one hand. Bamboo skewer doesn't follow the rules either. It just keeps picking up the seeds and setting them down. On a side note, this tap water has a pH of didn't check and an EC of not worried about it. These plants look pretty happy so far, though. I usually try to wait till after adding nutrients to thin out plants, but these radishes were impatient. Would you believe me if I told you I haven't been mixing my dry ingredients thoroughly? I did another video on the pest issues I encountered. I'll try not to ruin the ending for you. Oh. Don't be jealous, Danish cookie tin. It's just a disposable loaf pan. I knew this radish would mature before everything else, and I put the carrots in the middle because they like to grow tall. We just have to see how that works out. Have you heard the prophecy that was foretold? The gardener that grows the plants in the stone shall be king. Something has taken root in my radish's roots. Seems harmless. Maybe it's beneficial. Is it Jeb Oriza? Oh, lettuce, you fell before your time. Maybe a different fungus took you. The other lettuce looks fine. This other lettuce got a little reachy in the end, but it wasn't bitter. Is it possible to have too much cilantro? Like I suspected, the carrots just didn't have enough time to get to a decent size. With all the fungus floating around in the water, even I'm not going to eat the roots out of that. Your gardening safety tip for the day: don't eat rock wool. Radishes this large tend to be spicy, but most of the heat's in the skin. So what gardening rules do you like to break?